lastly, what he desired. You see, in the last point, the psalmist facts what he discovered. This earth, those who love him, those who live for him, will find it is full of God's love and majesty. But he doesn't stop there. He says what he desired. What did he desire? What was the psalmist's great desire? He says, teach me your statutes. Teach me your truth. Teach me your word. Teach me your law. You see, not only receiving the goodness of God on his mind, in his heart, but he desired more of God. He says, teach me your statutes. Remember, I've said, and I say it again, God's word to me is God's character imprint. The hymn writer wrote, the longer I serve him, the sweeter he grows. Wish I could remember more lines of those wonderful hymns. You see, grace unstinted must be followed by growth unstunted. When we fully receive God's grace, which we have through Jesus Christ our Lord, that should prompt us to grow deeper and stronger in our walk with God. You see, God's mercy must be the foundation on which to build a new kind of life. You see, mercy and truth must kiss each other. That's why Jesus was able to say, the truth will set you free. He's truth. But didn't he say, I am the way, the truth, and the life? So it is he who sets us free. His mercy and his truth, they must kiss each other. You see, life under God must be a life shaped by truth of God. And then I close with this question. Do we desire to be taught God's truth? Do we desire to be taught God's word, God's statutes, God's law? You know, many of us desire certain characteristics about our God. In other words, we want to take our God, the God of the Bible, and turn him into an idol and decorate him the way we like him to be decorated. But I'm learning very quickly, he's God and he does not change. He has exposed himself through his son Jesus Christ to us. And if ever I try to redecorate God according to my preference, I become an idol worshiper. And the psalmist knew that. The psalmist found what he realized, what he resolved, what he requested. The psalmist's feet, directly in the way of a perfect obedience, in a way of prompt obedience. The psalmist foes, even though the wicked ensnare me, I do not forget your law. In the midst of suffering, he turns his face towards his God because he knows in the end God is the one who's going to come through. The psalmist fervor. He said, at midnight I rise to praise you because of your righteous deeds. Was it because things have turned out so good for the psalmist that at midnight he gets the report that the stock market, his stock, has really jumped up high and he's made a lot of money? No. In the midst of a lot of pain and sorrow that we do not know about, he says, at midnight I rise to praise you because of your righteous deeds. The psalmist friends, I'm a companion of all who fear you, of those who keep your precepts. The psalmist facts, what he discovered, O Lord, the earth is full of your steadfast love. What he desired, keep me your statutes. I pray that the blessing God has blessed us with in this part of the world, we will hunger for his truth, that he may change us and make us who we ought to be. Remember, he created us in his image. That image has been marred by same by Satan and sin is part of eternity. And God is in the business of restoring us back. Maybe even more than what we are created in Garden of Eden. So can I say, come unto Him. Come to Him. Come to Him. If you've been standing a little distance because you said, you don't know what many bad things I've done. I don't think so. I will measure up. He says, come as you are. Come unto me. And that's, I'm not calling you to Pastor Valji or to Upper Kings Clear Church. I'm calling you to Jesus Christ. Because He's the one who died on Calvary's cross for your sin and my sin. Father, we thank you for your grace, your mercy, and your love. We thank you for your goodness, for your kindness. That you would allow us to know your word, hear your word, speak your word, read your word, sing your word, so that you may prepare our hearts before you and before this world. Now, Father, we pray you will go before us, you will guide us, you will protect us. You let your Holy Spirit apply this truth to our lives. For in Jesus' name we pray.